Hey dear students, a very good morning to all. Today we are going to learn one more method, that is a spherical coordinates. In the previous class, we have studied a Laplace equation involving a circle. Now today we are going to learn the new topic, that is Laplace equation in the spherical coordinates. So Laplace equation in the spherical coordinates, consider the Laplace equation nabla square u is equal to 0 or uxx plus uyy is equal to 0. The same equation you can write dou square u by dou x square plus dou square u by dou y square is equal to 0. The Laplace equation can be written in the spherical coordinates using the transformations. The following three transformations are there: x direction, y direction, z direction. Now let us x is equal to r sine theta cos pi, y is equal to r sine theta sin pi, z is equal to r cos theta. And this is the standard equation is there in the spherical coordinates, urr plus 2 by r u r plus 1 by r square u theta theta plus cot theta by r square u theta plus 1 by r square sine square theta u pi pi is equal to 0. Then here the r is the radius, zero is less than or equal to r is less than or equal to a, and theta is less than between 0 to 2 pi. And here we have a three variables. That is r, theta, pi, and pi is also lies between 0 to 2 pi. Now this is called equation number 1. Now let us find the solution of this Laplace equation in the form of the spherical coordinates. Let us assume the solution using the variable separable method in the form. Here it is a 3-dimensional. So then we are write the u of r comma theta pi is equals to r of r h of theta f of pi. But in the previous, we are only considered u of r comma theta is equal to x of x plus t of t. Now here we are considering r theta pi. Why in the previous u of r comma theta, here r theta pi means we are using the transformation theta pi and r. So r of r h of theta f of pi. So call this is equation number. Now substitute equation 2 in 1. How it is? From the equation 2, we get URR. Then differentiate this equation with respect to 2 times with respect to R partially. Then theta and pi are constants. We'll get URR is equals to R double dash of R. Then this value we get it. We'll get it. 2 by R. Then dou u by dou R. Then dou u by dou r is get only r dash of r, h and f as it is. Then this value you get from this one. U theta theta means you differentiate the equation 2 with respect to 2 times. Then u theta theta equals to, that is nothing but dou square u by dou theta square. So theta and this r and f, r and pi r keep constant. Then we'll get theta theta means h double dash theta, r and f as it is, and cot theta r square as it is, u theta, again we'll get the equation 2, dou u by dou theta is equal to r f h dash, and 1 by r square sin square theta as it is, u pi pi means differentiate equation 2, 2 times with respect to pi, then dou square u by dou pi square is equals to, then r h as it is, f double dash of pi. Then all the values are get from the equation 2, and all those values and all the expressions you can substitute in the equation 1. That is the meaning of plugging the equation 2 in equation 1. We get h f r double dash. That nothing but this dou u urr. Urr value is h f r double dash plus 2 by r h f r dash. This is it is a UR value 1 by R square. H dash means it is a this value. h dash. We need h dash here. U theta theta. This is you'll get. So 1 by r square h double dash f of r, that is plus cot theta by r square as it is, h dash r f plus 1 by r square sin square theta f h r is equals to 0. Here actually f double dash is there, but it is h f double dash of r. Though dividing throughout by h f r, first divide h f r, then after dividing multiplying r square. If suppose this h f r is dividing here, hf get cancelled, we'll get r double dash by r and multiply r square, then r square small r square into r double dash by r 2. Here r square is multiplied, r square by r only 2r, and hf r dash is divided by hfr, then hf get cancelled, r dash by r here divided by, then multiply r square get cancelled, then h double dash fr is divided by hfr, fr get cancelled, h double dash by h will get it, plus cot theta r square is multiplied, r square get cancelled, then h dash rf is divided by hfr, f rf rf get cancelled, h dash by h here, then 1 by r square sin square theta, r square is multiplied, r square get cancelled, 1 by sin square theta is equal to f double dash of f is equals to 0. Here f double dash is there, f double dash by f. This is called equation number 3. Now let we consider the two equations here, r square r double dash by r plus 2r r dash of r is equal to plus lambda square. And take the LCM r and capital R, take the right hand side, you'll get r square r double dash plus 2r r dash is equal to lambda square I. That lambda square r, you should take the left hand side, shifting to the left hand side. From this equation, we'll get r square r double dash plus 2r r dash minus r lambda square is equal to 0. Call this is equation number 4. So equation 3, again, we have only considered the first two terms. Then this is the one solution. The remaining three terms, we consider lambda square plus h double dash of h plus cot theta h dash by h plus 1 by sin square theta f double dash of f is equal to 0. Here this equation multiplying throughout by sin square theta, then each term multiplied, then if you multiply sin square theta this term, we'll get sin square theta lambda square plus sin square theta h double dash by h plus sin square theta cot theta h dash by h plus sin square theta by sin square theta 1 it is. We'll get only last term f double dash by f is equal to 0. Then this is we'll get after dividing the sin square theta. So let f double dash by f is equal to minus beta square. Where which one? We are this last term finding the solution. That is, we consider f double dash by f is equal to minus beta square. Then f double dash plus beta square f is equal to 0. This is called equation number 3. Then again, look here. Then once we know that f double dash f is minus beta square, this value we are substituting back in the equation. Which equation? This equation. Instead of f double dash by f is equal to minus beta square, then I wrote this one, sin square theta into lambda square plus sin square theta h double dash by h plus cot theta sin square theta h dash by h minus beta square is equal to 0. Just rearranging the terms, I writing sin square theta h double dash by h is the second term I writing first, and the third term, second term writing cot theta plus sin square theta h double by h, then this one lambda square sin square theta minus beta square are writing together, that is equal to 0. This is called equation number 3c. Now consider the r square r double dash plus 2r r dash minus lambda square r is equal to 0. To find this solution, take the substitution, because if it is not possible to find as it is a partial differential equation, let take small small r is equal to e to the prop t, then this is right in the logarithmic form, t is equal to log r by e. Then here this equation we can write in the differential auxiliary equation, d d minus 1 this term 2d minus lambda square r. So here d into d minus 1 d square d, then d square minus d plus 2d. 2d minus d we simplify, we get plus d minus lambda square r is equal to 0. This d is multiplied minus 1 minus d plus 2d, we will get plus d. D square plus d minus lambda square into r is equal to 0. So auxiliary equation m square plus m minus lambda square is equal to 0. Then it is a find the using the quadratic equation formula, that is x is equal to minus b plus r minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Here m is equal to the equation in terms of m, but in the original or auxiliary our original quadratic equation is x square plus bx plus c. So that is here m is equal to alpha 1 and m is equal to alpha 2. Suppose we finding the roots of this equation, that after simplification we consider alpha 1 whatever got the value, then here m is equal to alpha 2 second one, one time you take plus, another time minus. So alpha 1 alpha 2 are not equals, they're distinct, because when this is came then it is alpha 1 is not equal to r. That means roots are not equal, roots are different and distinct. So we write the solution r of t is equal to c1 e to the power of alpha 1 this one plus c2 e to the power of minus alpha 2 t. So our alpha 1 is, what is the alpha 1? Alpha 1 is minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 4 lambda square by 2. What is this alpha 2? Minus 1 in minus root of 1 plus 4 lambda square by 2. So substitute the, that is t value, r of r is equals to c1 e to the power of alpha 1. What is t? T is here, we're taking the substitution, where here r is equal to e to the power of t, then t is equal to log r. We are substituting that one here. Instead of t, we are writing log r. C2 e to the power of minus alpha 2 log r. So r of r is equals to c1 e to the power of log e to the power of r alpha 1. Then this alpha 1, we are writing again in the logarithmic form. We know that very well. Logarithm of m into logarithm of m into logarithm of n to the base e can be written as logarithm of m to the power of n to the base e. So using that identity, we can write alpha 1 log r is log r to the power of alpha 1 to the base e. And this is also using the same method here, c2 e to the power of log r to the power of minus alpha 2. So r of r is equals to, this is also r, it is not t. C1 r to the power of alpha 1, c2 r to the power of minus alpha 2. We know that very well. Logarithm of r to the power of alpha 1 to the base, we write the in the simplification form r to the power of alpha 1. E to the power of log r to the power of minus alpha 2 written c2 r to the power of minus alpha 2. Now this is called equation number 2. Now solution of equation 3b is given as follows. 3b is this one. This equation f double dash plus beta square f is equal to 0. It is like d square plus 1 is equal to 0. Then d square is equal to minus 1, d is equal to plus or minus I. When the roots are imaginary, the solution of 3b we can write in this form. Which form? Here, f of pi is equal to, because if it's imaginary means roots are imaginary, the solution is right in terms of cos and sine. So c3 cos b pi, sorry, beta pi plus c4 sine beta pi. Because this is equation 4b. So now let t is equal to cos theta. Take this substitute, t is equal to cos theta. dt is equal to minus sine theta d theta. Our aim is to find the ds by d theta. Ds by d theta can be written as by using the chain rule, or ds by dt into dt by d theta. So ds by dt as it is, dt by d theta, d theta take left hand side, dt by d theta is equal to minus sine theta. Here I wrote minus sine theta. So again differentiate this equation with respect to d by d theta, with respect to theta. Then d square h by d theta square is left hand side, right hand side d by d theta of this term. Then d h by d theta, this totally, d by d theta of d h by d theta, d h by d theta is d h by d t minus sine theta. So again d by d theta can be written as like this only, d h by d t, d t by d theta. So here d by d t of this as it is, d h by d t minus sine theta into d t by d theta. So d by d t, d h by d t is d square h by d t square, then minus sine theta, again d t by d theta is there, d t by d theta is minus sine theta here. So minus sine theta, minus sine theta whole square. Minus even powers, we'll get positive sign only. So we can write sine square theta into d square h by dt square. What value it is? D square h by d theta square value is sine square theta into d square h by dt square. So d square h by dt square can be written as h double dash. D square h by d theta square is equal to sine square theta h double dash. Equation, equating this equation 3c, we get, look, this equation equating 3c. What is equation 3c? 3c is like this, sine square h double dash by h plus cot theta sine square theta h double dash by h plus lambda sine square theta minus beta square is equal to 0. Then comparing this with this equation d square h by sine square theta h double dash, then we can get the, consider 3c, sine square theta h double dash, cot theta sine square theta h dash plus lambda square sine square theta minus beta square into h is equals to 0. Then here we are using this equation, this identity, wherever d square h by, that means a h theta theta it is, h theta theta is equal to sine square theta by h double dash. So then we are taking the substitution, letting t is equal to cos theta. Then we know that sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. But sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Cos is here t. Then sine square theta is equal to 1 minus t square. That is sine square is equal to 1 minus t square. And look here, what we are doing means this equation, multiplying both sides, cos theta, cos theta. Then in the right hand side of writing in terms of cos theta t, in the left hand side of writing cos theta as it is. So cos theta into, why I'm writing means we need this term here. So cos theta sine square theta is equal to t of 1 minus t square. So here all the values we are converting in terms of this transformation. Sine square theta is here 1 minus t square, 1 minus t square. So h double dash. So cot theta sine square theta is t into 1 minus t square h dash. And lambda square as it is, sine square theta is again 1 minus t square minus beta square into h is equals to 0. So this term, we add sine square theta h double dash is there here. So sine square theta whole square it is. Look here, sine square theta h double dash. Then already here in the equation 3c, 3c sine square theta is there. Sine square theta, then h double dash. H double dash value is what there? H double dash value. H double dash of theta value is sine square theta h double dash. So this, therefore you will get here 1 minus t square whole square. So after get this equation, we divide the total equation 1 minus t square here. So 1 minus t square whole square divided by 1 minus t square. You will get numerator 1 time 1 minus t square h double dash plus 1 minus t square is get cancelled. This. Only will get t h dash. Then 1 minus t square is divided here. Only will get lambda square minus beta square divided by 1 minus t square h is equal to 0. Which is the, look here, this is the particular form of the partial differential equation. That is known as the Legendre equation. And its solution is like this. H of theta is equal to C5 P lambda T plus C6 Q lambda T. T solution. Then theta solution H of theta is equal to C5 P lambda theta plus C6 Q lambda theta. This two, both together it is equation 4C. If we solving this one, H double dash H is there. Then we'll get H of theta solution. So where P lambda, what are here? I mentioned this P lambda and Q lambda. P lambda, Q lambda are the Legendre functions of first and second kind. So final solution will get it. U of r comma theta pi is equals to C1. Look here. We are writing the U of r, U of theta, U of pi together. Then what will get it? First solution is here. What first solution is this one. R of r is equal to C1 r to the power of alpha 1 plus C2 r to the power of minus alpha 2 and F of pi is this solution 4a, 4b and final solution. So final solution is this one in terms of t and theta. So finally we get u of r comma theta pi is C1 r to the power of alpha 1 plus C2 r to the power of minus alpha 2 C3 cos beta pi plus C4 sin beta pi into C5 P lambda theta plus C6 Q lambda theta. This is called equation number 5. Now using the condition when r is equal to 0, then this U of r comma theta pi tends to infinity. So r to the power of minus lambda square can be, r to the power of minus alpha 2 can be written as 1 by r to the power of alpha square. When r tends to 0, look here, when r to 1 by 0, any number below is infinity. That means here u r comma theta pi tends to infinity, which is a impossible because C2 is equal to 0. If C2 is equal to 0, it is impossible. Then if we that therefore we consider which is a impossible when C2 is equal to 0. That means r to the power of minus infinity. We left this one, we'll get the solution. U of r comma theta pi is equal to C1 r to the power of alpha when C2 is equal to 0. Using this condition, this term goes to 0. And this term goes to 0 means the remaining term is the solution. C1 r to the power of alpha 1 into C3 cos beta pi plus C4 sin beta pi into C5 P lambda theta plus C6 P lambda theta is the required solution. I hope you are understanding. Today's this class, we can meet in the next period.